And welcome. This is Nuke Marine presenting Let's Read Japanese, core series for the reading of Japanese text alongside its audio counterpart. Today's episode is Let's Read Japanese, Kino Nani Tabeta, episode 15. This is the last episode of the Kino Nani Tabeta series. These were the three episodes that were the specials. They were basically episodes and it extended the series. It wasn't like they were standalones. And it worked quite well for the story. There is a movie. I won't be doing any Let's Read that. First off, I don't have access to it yet. And I'm pretty sure it's going to be different than the structure what we're used to with the drama. At least I noticed that when it went like a drama like Confidence Man JP, which was episodic. The movies, not as big of a fan, but they're okay. So anyway, I imagine this type of movie for this series would be following the same lines. All right. After this, I will be going back to Time Taxi, finish up the second half of that, then to fourth season of Shin Ya Shokudo, which is the Netflix version. Season 4 and 5 is seasons 1 and 2 on Netflix, the Tokyo stories. I'll be doing those, and along with a couple of other dramas. There is an issue with the language reactor, what used to be Learn Languages with Netflix. I get how they wanted to change it, because they changed the name, so they make sure, hey, it's going to apply to more than just Netflix. That way they can keep just one name. And then to say, hey, is it working on YouTube or Netflix? Or maybe it might work later with Amazon or some other. So they can keep the title of the thing, keep the same name. They can just make it all fall under one app as opposed to trying to have like multiple apps. So that could be kind of useful. I can see that. That way it also falls under one account. I'm not a programmer, so I don't know what goes into that. It's a very good program. Obviously, it is dependent upon the website said they don't control Netflix. Netflix does its own thing, and Netflix does not care about some third-party app, some very small third-party app that deals with language learning. They don't care. they should. I think they could have actually been making quite a bit of money if they had leveraged their site to also be about language learning, maybe as an additional cost. You know, somebody buys in like $5 a month, and then they get a language learning account. And it lets them have access and introduces them to videos that say, hey, you know, these two videos, they can connect to each other, whatever. But again, that's neither here nor there. Money on the tables, though. Beyond that, yeah, this episode is just going to be ending ending this particular series. So with that said, let me just do my usual intro. So if you end up liking this video, remember for you guys on YouTube, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment. Feedback's always appreciated. All right. If you like this series, and if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel to see more series like this. I plan to continue this into the future. This all falls under the Let's Learn Japanese project. Now that is, if you appreciate what I'm doing with that in helping the Japanese learning community, you can support that via the Patreon. The links for that in the description below, as well as links to the community Discord and the website that Otaku Dave put together. Finally, if you'd like to hire me on commission or technical assistance one-on-one, usually though it's one-on-one advice to walk you through the setup process and getting using these resources that I talk about now and again. And also for people who are trying to get restarted and they basically want to get back and learn Japanese, but maybe focus in the direction they saw that I took it because they like my personal approach. Again, the hourly rates and the payments are on the Patreon. The direct link specifically to that is also in the description. Okay. Got one viewer on Twitch. Hey, viewer. And sorry I've been gone for a while. Try to make this back to being more consistent. I didn't do an hourly on, for those of you who do on Twitch, I didn't do the news today or for the last few days, but I need to get back into doing that also because that's been fun. But I plan to be doing on Twitch, doing three videos today, which, you know, on YouTube will be released over like 17th, 18th, and 19th. Again, get caught back up to my 14 days. Part of it has been laziness. Part of it was the Netflix update that caused the language reactor or learn languages of Netflix to go down. And the interface just sucked. it looks like it's kind of sort of fixed. Not completely. There's still some problems with it. But hopefully it all works out. Beyond that, yeah, let's get started. The video is going to be up above. It's going to be kind of smaller. I can't help that. But I try to make sure is that the subtitles here fit within the screen. You're going to hopefully see most of the subtitles are smaller font. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it bigger. And Well, we'll see if we can get it to work. Beyond that, all right, let's get into it. Let's see, we're at 5 minutes. It's a little late start in this, but all right, both of your pieces. Okay, here we go.
待って。残金が6627円ってことは、そもそも食費の半月分よりちょっと多めの1万5000円もらってんだから、6627引いて、もう8373円も使っちゃってる。ちょっと待って、マジで。まだ1週間しか経ってないのに、どうしよう。何無駄遣いしちゃったんだろう。待って。
Make sure about that.
まだ1週間しか経ってないのに、どうしよう。何無駄遣いしちゃったんだろう。待って。
So if you remember on the previous episode, he talked about how he's going to start working in saving money, try to do a little bit of conserving. Not being cheap, but just make sure watch what they spend. ¥319, but what? I mean.
シロさんに怒られる。あ、いや、自分で出したことにしよう。でもそれって隠蔽？
隠蔽？それで隠蔽？
でもそれって隠蔽？
いい、偉い人だって、もう都合の悪いこと全部隠蔽してんだから、もう手裏剣かけちゃったりしてさ。
シュレーター、シュ
さあ、シュレッダーかけ、偉い人だって、もう都合の悪いこと全部隠蔽してんだから、もうシュレッダーかけちゃったりしてさ。
ただいまー。
Very comedic.
おかえり、シロさん。大丈夫？なんか大変だったみたいね。
ああ、今日また別件が入ってさ。
Different.
でかい、今日また別件が入ってさ、でかい民事再生案件一つで十分手一杯なのに。
でかい民事再生。No, that's not, that's different. Should be a reclaimed or Minji Saisei Anken. It's probably like a recovery, probably that one right there, reclamation. They don't have it there. Restored Anken. Yeah. A public civil marriage probably restarted. Okay. Saise. Minji Saise Anken.
でかい民事再生案件一つで十分手一杯なのに。
Should be full. Hands are full. Teippai. Uno moi mamasu. My hands full. Teippai. 十分teippai なのに。
でかい民事再生案件一つで十分手一杯なのに。つまんな、源氏、起きて待ってくれてたんだな。
俺もほら、やることあったから。
ごめん、源氏、俺事務所で飯食っちゃったんだよ。連絡しようと思ってたのに。 すまん。
いいよ全然。
いやだってせっかく今日も飯用意してくれてたのに。明日は食うよ朝飯。
いいってシロさん、朝はパン派だし残っ
パン派だし
残ったおかずはシロさん、朝はパン派だし残ったおかずは俺が昼に食えばいいんだから。残ったおかずは俺が昼に食えばいいんだから気にしないで。
いやでも
それより早くお風呂入って寝なよ、明日も早いんでしょ。
ほんとごめんなケンジ。
ゆっくり。やっぱもう少し買い物工夫しなきゃな。
考え出した方法。Method. New method of ice. 工夫。Design idea. 工夫。買い物工夫しなきゃな。
やっぱもう少し買い物工夫しなきゃな。
買い物ですか？
うん。
マセミカ？So, nah, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure it's a Haruka, Mika, probably Mika.
買い物ですか？
うん、うん、
近所のスーパーで。
近所のスーパーで。
特に何も考えずに買ってますけど。私はほとんど自炊しないからな。私は近所のスーパーで特に何も考えずに買ってますけど。私はほとんど自炊しないからな。
だよね。
もう二人とも全然節約の参考になんない。ダメダメ。もう二人とも全然節約の参考になんない。ダメ。も
ケンちゃんだって元は金遣い緩かったじゃない。
これからは堅実になるの。
うん、堅実。これから堅実になるの。
これからは堅実になるの。
And by the way, that's a good idea. Just because you just got started out doesn't mean, oh, don't worry about it because you didn't do it before. Yeah, it's okay to take something serious. You know, you do studyingexercise, help. You don't have to go, be careful about going overboard because you can burn yourself out, but try to make sure it's like, hey, you know what, just because I didn't do it before doesn't mean it's not important now. And, you know, because the thing you start noticing when you start adding it up, like, even if it's just like saving of, somehow you save $5 a day, just somehow you figure it out. You know, again, in a month's time, that's $150. Somehow. And, you know, people say, well, how can, oh, look at Mr. Moneybags over there, able to save five. It's like, okay, don't bitch at him. Like, you save whatever you can. I don't know what your...budget is, all right? So I'm not trying, so, you know, you hear it on, usually online all the time, like they downplay every type of advice they give it out because they say, oh, it doesn't apply to them because they're this unique snowflake and how dare you not even realize that they're unique snowflake status. So that kind of gets annoying. It's like, okay, look, you get the idea. It's saying $5 over here, but if you can only save a dollar, then save a fucking dollar. Who cares, all right? Whatever you can save on a day, just do that. And there are ways we can put away in a place where you don't lose money, but where you put it. You know, hopefully, because again, I know that banks make it very difficult to put money, save small amounts of money. I get that because of their monthly fees and shit they like to tack on to punish poor people. I get that. But again, though, there's nothing wrong with the concept of saving. You know, and try to do it on a little bit, like change whatever your lifestyle is to, and then make sure that money that you save from that lifestyle change is put away so you can see it grow. So you see a benefit for the effort that you're putting into it. Otherwise, if you don't, you're going to spend it for something else. That's the thing. That's the thing you got to be careful about, because when people save, then again, they put it toward, instead of the benefit of saving it, they spend it. So you didn't really save it. You just altered what you bought. Okay. Anyway, let's keep going. What do you got at?堅実。
これからは堅実になるの。この間なんか卵買うのに特売やってる駅前のスーパーまで行ったんだよ。
なのその後いつもの中村屋に行ったら、なのその後いつもの中村屋に行ったら、
こっちの方が安い、しかも30円も。
もうがっくりきちゃったよ。
チラシアプリ見ればいいのよ。
I don't know that kanji. Okay, Joe. I mean that part. The yeah, it always suggests it's Joel based, or precious stones based because of that particular radical. But Akiko.
チラシアプリ見ればいいのよ。
アプリ？
ほら、こういうの。住所登録しておくと、近所のスーパーのチラシが見られるから。
わ、ほんとだ。
2軒回ったりするとき失敗がないから便利よ。
本日の特売品もこう分かりやすい。レヒコさん、さすが。
レヒコさん。レヒコ。あれ、レヒコ。
レヒコさん、さすが。主婦歴長。
主婦歴。さすが、主婦歴。
玲子さん、さすが主婦歴長。
Of course, the owner cheated on her a few times in the story.
尊敬。
見て見て、おすすめのレシピも出てくる。
本当だ。
でもさ、節約ってたかだか10円20円の問題だろ。そしたら一箇所でまとめて買って早く家に帰った方が得じゃない？なら時間と労力の無駄だと思うんですけど。
No, that's actually a legit reason. It's like, okay, the amount of time you're spending trying to save like 10 or 20 cents here and there when you're doing sales, is it worth the time you spent, you know, like going to different stores, like you're shopping one place versus shopping at two different places. But if you look at savings as, you know, kind of like day trading, it's like, okay, you put a little bit of time, let's say you took an hour to save $20. That's a, well, again, that's $20 an hour. You just say, I mean, that's the equivalent of doing $20 an hour job. That's what you did. I don't know if I'd go this insane where it's like 20 or 30 yen. That just, but again, that's why you kind of like maybe not, but he's doing this on the daily. And the reason why they buy it, they're able to buy daily so that they can save, you know, they have fresh food. So they got to be able to store it and then use it and then go back. So there are some benefits to where, okay, these 30, you know, 30 cents here, 60 cents there, you know, will add up, you know, for the benefit there. As long as, you know, again, plan your recipe or your dinner around the, you know, the sales that are available. Okay, so there's that. So there's a benefit there as well for variety. Some of it maybe for people is just a game, you know, so there's nothing wrong there either. That said, though, I mean, looking for good deals, if you're going to also do what you saw in the previous one, where it's doing meal prep, like they're basically prepping a large amount of food to be stored, like put in the freezer and to be used over time. There's a big benefit then for, you know, if you get a special deal and you say, hey, oh, well, let's just get a bunch of eggs and this coleslaw and this carrots because there happen to be good sales on it on that particular day. And then do, you know, a week or 2 weeks worth of meal prep. There is a benefit there as well. So, you know, again, it's not something I do, but I can appreciate the fact that people like doing it. And, you know, especially if you have the tools to where you're not wasting too much time looking for it. Like, again, this application says, hey, you know what? Here are what the special deals are. Okay, cool. You know what to get at one store, and then you go on to the next store. It saves you time. So I think that's a good idea. Anyway, let's keep going.
婚通り越して殺意まこう。
離婚通り。離婚通り越して殺意。
離婚通り越して殺意まこう。
玉ねぎはとりあえず買い置きしとこっかな。
明日それ特売で1個19円になるから。
Hmm. You don't really hear her talk.
あ、シロさんだ。
すまん、もう飯作ってる？今日も遅いから俺の分は大丈夫。
あ、大丈夫。まだ作ってないよ。連絡ありがとう。お仕事頑張ってね。
じゃん。
必殺シロさん御用達シンプルタッパ
ー。一冊シロさん。
シン必殺シロさん御用達シンプルタッパー。副菜は作り置きできるもんね。
副菜。菜でしょ。OK。副菜は作り置き。
副菜は作り置きできるもんね。
予算の減りが抑えられてきたぞ。
こっち。白さんのシャツは特に念入り。
念の入り。念入り。特に念入りに。
特に念入りに。
特に念入りに。
シロさん。真っ白。
このレンコンのきんぴら。
レンコン。レンコン。レンコン。OK。レン、actually, let me look that up. Why am I drawing a blank?Oh, okay. God damn it. And then kimpira.
Parito してて美味しい。このレンコンのきんぴら。Parito してて美味しい。
That should be crispy, right? Parito?Crackling. Yeah, crisply toasted. Parito.
このレンコンのきんぴら。
このレンコンのきんぴら。
パリッとしてて美味しい。お酢を入れると味が締まるってシロさんに教えてもらったの。お酢を入れると味が締まるってシロさんに教えてもらったの。
Well, that's a full phrase. 味が締まる。
ほんとシロさんってもう天才。もしかしてシロさん、いっぺん帰ってきてまた出てった
？At once?Came back and left. Then 帰ってきてまた出てた。
一遍帰ってきてまた出てった。やだ、全然気づかなかった。本当ごめん。ああもう。
Of Hopefully the audio is good here. I didn't even bother. I didn't forget to even check. I think the audio should be good. Test, test, test.
いいよ。お前も疲れてるんだから。あと、レンコンのきんぴら、うまかった。夜中全部食っちまった。
もう、全然いいよ。
シャツのアイロンも助かった。ありがとう。
ああ、もう気づいてくれてるこの感じ。惚れ直す。大好き。
しかしここは。賢い妻のごとき冷静さでどういたしまして。
That's very formal. You really don't hear people say どういたしまして in Japanese. It's like いいよ、これこそ or something like that, but yeah, it does feel formal. Seem to have something on it.俺はわびを言われて時の。Yeah, yeah, so it's, yeah, it's gotta be honor, definitely honorific. どう?
なんで?
He dropped the boxes, okay.Okay. So that's a lecture. Kodan Seisaku. Yeah, that should be a lecture. Here it is. Kodan Seisaku. Seisaku Shou. Kodan Seisaku Shou.
なんで講談制作所の関西支社の資料ってなんでデータになってないの。
ああもう今日はお昼いいもん食べましょう。うなぎがいいわ。志野さん、あのうな重全員分大丈夫。お代はね私が出すから。大丈夫。志野さん、あのうな重全員分
うな重、Okay. Unagi is good. Unajo. Okay. Zenbu.
大丈夫。お代はね。後ろさん、あの、うな重全員分。大丈夫。お代はね、私が出すから。はい。
ああ、ついにお母さんのうなぎ発注が出た。急ぐ。わしと切って。あーついにお母さんのうなぎ発注が出た。忙しい時って食べ物に救い求めがちだよね。
あの今藤沢印刷さんがいらしてますけど。
印刷インクスケ I know it should be like a print, right? Printing. Okay.
もちろん、
あの今藤沢印刷さんがいらしてますけど。
もちろん藤沢さんの分もよ。おいしいもの食べてちょっとは元気出してもらわなきゃ。
加計先生やっぱり面倒見いいよね今。
面倒見 looking after someone right、
今、加計先生、やっぱり面倒見いいよね。今、こっちも忙しいのに。
藤沢さん、結局奥様と離婚されたんですか？
今、
藤沢さん結局奥様と離婚されたんですか？
奥さんは最後まで嫌がってたけど、 家族に負担をかけるのは見てられないって。藤沢さんが、奥さんは最後まで嫌がってたけど、家族に負担をかけるのは見てられないって藤沢さんが譲らなかったらしいよ。
辛いわね。
どうぞ。
And yeah, it's like, yeah, like it, it's not like a divorce is automatic. You know, so you gotta have both people agree to it. Otherwise, I guess it becomes a very lengthy process.
So,
すいません、こんな贅沢なもの。でも、すいません。
食欲がなければ無理しないでください。でも、食べた方がいいですよ。銀行との交渉は、ここから体力勝負ですから。
妻は、娘たちは、実家で肩身の狭い思いをしてないだろうか。
肩身の狭い。肩身の狭い。What about 肩身? Okay, the body.
実家で肩身の狭い思いをしてないだろうか。ちゃんとしたもの食べられてんのかなと思うと。
食べましょう。いただきます。うん、うまい。やっぱりうまいな、うなぎは。
うなぎ、if you haven't had it, it's very good. I like it. It's got some small bones, so you gotta chew it well so the bones don't like get, you know, too stuck. But it's not too, I mean, not dangerous. The bones aren't dangerous, just, you still gotta chew them down. Yeah, very good. I usually, you know, have it with sushi, and it's normally how I have it, but also, you know, we've also had it.Gone to a restaurant for unagi by itself, you know, served over unagi don, not unagi don, but unagi over, you know, with a box, you know, lacquer box like you see with the rice on top. Kind of expensive, but it's a it tastes really good.
Nanda kanda tabete shimau.
Nanda kanda. Nanda kanda.
なんだかんだ食べてしまう人間っていうのは食べたもんですね。すいません。
いいじゃないですか。うまいもんが目の前にあれば食いますよ。それにうまいもんが目の前にあれば食いますよ。それにうまいもん食べたときに。それをまた一緒に食べたい、食べさせてあげたいと思う人が心の中にいる人間は何があってもやり直せます。
Good advice.
今日はね、もし余っても冷凍しておけるハヤシライスです。
ハヤシライスです。 Basically it's a Hayashi rice, basically a tomato soup.I didn't realize it at the time, but yeah, I mean, it is. And I wondered if, like, because I never heard of it before, I, you know, till about like a decade ago. I never knew that, like, tomato soup goes with grilled cheese and tomato soup goes good together. I didn't realize that. So I wondered, like, would you eat, like, hayashi rice, but maybe with a very good, high quality grilled cheese? Let's say, like, sourdough, like the type on the movie Chef, you know, sourdough, four types of cheese grilled just right.You know, have that with, you know, a good quality hayashi rice, it would just be like, sounds like that would go great together. And yeah, it does taste good. It does taste good. Yeah. Where are we at here? Oh, another case at the courthouse. Saibansho. That should be the courthouse, right? Yeah, Court of Justice. Saibansho.
Hasan Kanzai ni no shikoto. Bekken de Saibansho kara Hasan Kanzai ni no shikoto.
The person Sankai-san, bankruptcy administrator Hasan Kanzai-nin. Hasan, let's see what we got. Hasan, bankruptcy. Hasan Kanzai-nin, so that's be the administrator. Yeah.
ハサン関西人、ハサン関西人。ハサン関西人の仕事頼まれてしまいました。なんで今？ああ、でも断れないのよね。裁判所の依頼は断ると二度と来なくなるから。So
it's kind of a script situation. If you turn down this request, they don't ask again. Where again, there's benefits. Like, maybe they're a little rushed out. That sounds weird. Like, it's like, hey, look, we can't handle the caseload at the moment. Pass it on. You think, you know, again, they... It feels weird, like, oh, they won't entrust again. It's like, no, it's like, you should have a list of people to go through. It's like, I mean, that's a better way of running it. So you're not like, hey, look, we just don't have the caseload. We want to do this. But, like, at the moment, we can't. We're swamped. And I remember that when you watch Legal Eagle, where... Again, he has pretty good insight into some of this stuff. You know, it's similar, like when people, you know, there's the public defenders, and a lot of it, like a lot of the law offices, you know, are part of the public defense. They're part of the public defense defender cycle as well. You know, and part of the requirements is, you know, participate in that. But you know, I'm sure they'd have to, like, hey, we just don't have the case. We don't have the personnel at the moment. You know, can this be passed off? And if not, then yeah, obviously, like, well, no, we don't have the. You know, we already went through it, and then you're the one. Now we're going to have to go and make it mandatory. And so they have to, like, kind of dig deep and bring one up, and then the next law office will bring up their person as well. You know, so, you know, it depends. You got to be careful because, you know, even in the military, when you're looking for stuff like volunteers or doing help for another company, like, you kind of have to also take a hard line if you're the one making the request. It's like, okay, it's not really a request. It is a demand, but we're being nice about it. We're going to say, can you do this? We'll look for other people. But then when no one else is going to do it, then yeah, now it has to turn into a demand. So there's that as well. I don't know how that works here, what's happening here, but that sounds like a shitty statement that if they don't do it, they can't, because they do want it. They do want it. It's not at the moment. And they're worried, like, they got to take it. And so do you take it and do a shitty job on it on the hopes that you get another? But if you do a shitty job, are they going to ask you to do another one? Yeah, I don't know how that works. All right, anyway.
裁判所の依頼は断ると二度と来なくなるから。ここで加計先生抜けるの？嘘でしょ。Oh,
I was hitting the wrong button.
裁判所の依頼。Okay,
anyway.
裁判所の依頼は断ると二度と来なくなるから。ここで加計先生抜けるの？嘘でしょ。もうピザ取りましょう。ピザ二枚いきますか？
ランチョンマットとか敷いちゃったもんね。ランチョンマット。あ、ランチマット。オッケー。ランチョンマットとか敷いちゃったもんね。いや、可愛い。じゃあ、当事務所で、明後日10時でお願いします。先生と社長以外で会社の状況に詳しい方。
当事務所。OK。
先生とじゃあ当事務所で、あさって10時でお願いします。先生と社長以外で会社の状況に詳しい方。どなたがいらっしゃいますか。ええ。
タタタタタラタ中村や。タタタタ。中村。あ、シロさんだ。
今日も遅くなる。本当にすまない。
I get it's dramatic and all that, but yeah, you gotta be very careful about becoming flustered and doing stuff, because then that creates other accidents. And sometimes you gotta say, okay, stop. Just say, okay, something bad happened, but don't let them get frustration where now you're gonna create more problems. You gotta be, that does happen, by the way. That's a legit thing. And sometimes it's a mindset where it's like, take back, take a deep breath. Shit's already fucked up. Ain't got any more fucked up. It's already fucked up. So then go about fixing it, you know. And yeah, it sucks, but okay, buy a new shirt. Yeah, that was stupid. At least there's this water, but you know, you still have to dry it out and re-iron it.
Nani?どうした？
どうした？
もうずっとシロちゃんと一緒にご飯食べれてないの。
食べれてないの。
かれこれ3週間も。さすがに俺もう限界。
さあ、そんな無理すんなって。ね、シロさんがさいない時にこそ逆に。
あ、wait, wait. I think you said シロさんがさいない時。
シロさんがさいない時にこそ逆に自分の好きにしたらいいんだよ。自分の自由にしてたら少しは寂しさだって紛れるだろ。
Should be parting, right? Hmm. 入れるんだろ？寂しさだって。
自分の自由にしてたら、少しは寂しさだって紛れるだろ？
Hmm.
Hmm. 卵あるし。
卵あるし。Oh, oh, never mind. Sometimes I wonder, like, is that like a... is that a new field? Is that a food or a dinner or something?Or a meal, and no, no, it's just like, oh yeah, there's eggs, there's...
Saiyai no tori momo niku aru shi.
Saiyai? Love most, the dearest. Saiyai tori momo. Yeah, no, that's thai. Tori momo niku aru shi.
Saiyai no tamago aru shi. Saiyai no tori momo niku aru shi. Tamanegi mo chanto 1 ko 19 yen no tokubai de getto shite aru mon ne. もう半分とかやってらんない。玉ねぎ丸々1個。みじん切りも適当
適当I saw it, it was on the chef show, you know, and they said one guy said that the one chef told him like, yeah, just put saran wrap around the eyes, you know, just wrap around the eyes andJust so it doesn't get, so you can still see, but it's not getting into your eyes. So you're not like, you know, crying, you know, it's not, if you're affected by the onions, heavily affected by the onions. I'm not as affected, so I'm pretty good. Because, you know, not everyone can chop, some people, you know, if you chop it underwater, yeah, that's going to have to, that'll reduce the most. But then, of course, now your onions are underwater. So that's going to affect how it's going to be used for cooking. So again, just depends.
寂しくて泣いてるんじゃないもん。
寂しくて泣いてるんじゃないもん。
鶏もも肉も1枚全部
使っちゃう。
鶏肉と玉ねぎをオリーブオイルで炒めて、鶏肉に火が通ったらここにご飯を投入。具の量が多いから
I like that. 投入 It should be like throw in, right? 投入 yeah.
具の鶏肉に火が通ったらここにご飯を投入。具の量が多いから
具の量
ご飯も2膳分だもんね。
2膳全然small dining table. So I wonder if zenbun is that like cooking chopsticks? Yeah, right there. Ashiichi zen.
Hmm. 具の量が多いからご飯も2膳分だもんね。炭水化物も
炭水化物 So that should be the carbs 炭水化物も
執着しないぞ
執着God dang it There it is again Keep forgetting what this is Hesitate, don't hesitate しないぞ Okay 炭水化物炭水化物躊躇しないぞ躊躇 And really I again these are not this is a complicated kanji this one is not a complicated kanji but they both kind of have the similar meaning if I recall yeah so they're both basically for hesitate and so in these cases usually when you learn these in by frequency you'll see that these are kind of by each other because again they're almost at the similar frequency very similar frequency andYou know, you see, if they're only using, if this is the main word they're using, then it's good to learn it like hesitate one, hesitate two, instead of like trying to create like two different unique words for hesitate, like Hazig tends to do. I think he would have been better off just like give it a number. So like rose one, rose two, to say which part of the word in rose it appears, or grape one, grape two. I think I've mentioned that before. So same way here, if I was going to learn this, instead of creating again, there may be the Hazig keyword, but I may just think of it as being...one and two you know hesitate one and two same like aisatsu the two kanjis there they're only if you learn them like I said there's only one common word that appears in that's aisatsu those two kanji but you see those kanji are high in frequency because that word is used a lot so if you learn it it's best to learn it in relation to that word and in which position just because of when it comes to if you ever want to write it from memory all right let's keep going
炭水化物も躊躇しないぞ
コンソメ躊躇しないぞコンソメ what is that? カリュー、グラニュオ、カー what? A grain? Really? How frequent is that? Well, okay Wow, that's I mean, it's not a I mean, it's fruit and headmaybe a little seeds. Okay, I mean, granule. Karyu. Consomme karyu.
Consomme karyu.
Karyu.
Ketchup tappuri.
Ketchup tappuri.
Puri
puri. Puri
puri. Shio kosho.
Shio kosho. Shosho.
Chicken rice no.
Ooh, that does look good.And is he going to cover it with eggs? Is it going to be omelet ice? Chicken ice?
Konai da tsukutte oita hayashi rice no sauce.
Okay. Did he make that or was it a, probably a toroto, like in a plastic bag? So, yeah, or not a plastic bag, but in a sealed kit, in a sealed bag.
Chinshite!今日はとことん不健康に行こうかなと思ってたんだけど。
とことん、とことん。今日はとことん不健康。Unhealthy? 不 健康and healthily. 不健康に行こうかな。
今日はとことん不健康に行こうかなと思ってたんだけど、これ食べないと悪くなっちゃうしな。
シロさん、副菜の鬼だからな。
副菜の鬼。Small servings. Sanoi. Okay. I'm not sure.
Shiro-san.副菜の鬼だからな。影響されて、こんなに作っちゃってる俺。バカだよね。
いよいよ、いよ
真打ちの。
真打ちの。
卵投入。シロさんは絶対作ってくれない。卵3個使ったオムレツ。
オムライス。
だってオムレツって卵3個くらい使った方が絶対綺麗に作れるもんね。マヨネーズと牛乳を少々、塩、
okay.
胡椒、
Pepper.
ふわふわに作るぞ。
Make it fluffy. ふわふわ作るぞ。
バターも。
バターも。
たっぷり。あれは
贅沢。さあ。
さあこの半熟とろっとろの。
半熟。ああ。I mean half heat, but 半熟。Okay. Wait a minute. 食もまだ十分いるね。Cookie. So half cooked. Yeah, half cooked. Hanjuku. So I was thinking like, if you've seen it, like I might think it like half heat, but I guess it's like, also if you think about the mellow right there. But yeah, half cooked. Hanjuku. Half cooked eggs. And I like how you say, you know, you make it as an omelet.Half cooked, you put the omelet on top, then you slice the top and it kind of folds over the rice. It's kind of interesting, you know, when you see it working, I think it's kind of cool. Alright, let's see if he wakes it works. Okay. Oh, he's doing it a little differently, okay. That's hayashi rice.
Omurice no kansei!
It looks very good, but that's like really high carb. That's a lot of rice. That is a lot of rice. And I think I would assume omelet rice is supposed to be a very cheap meal, but it can be made. It can be a cheap meal, but still be made in a good way. That's the same with, I like how you said, Chef Roy, the chef show, he said, you know, you know, it doesn't have to be about the best ingredients.Or fancy ingredients either. It's just like you can take normal ingredients and with a little bit more extra care and whatnot, you can make something that not only is delicious but presentable. Just in how you know preparations and especially a lot of it with the additional stuff. I mean, you know what they say, like the good chef starter pack is always like olive oil, salt, and garlic. You know, just those things like kind of like the staple of you know, what's supposed to be like fancy cooking. But really, it's not fancy, just the additional things that, you know, the average person maybe not going to think about, you know, making food, you know, trying to improve the presentation of it. Both the presentation, how it looks, but also how it smells and how it tastes.
Itadakimasu!
Oh!
Shiro-san?
Shiro-san?
Kaetta yo!終わったの？
いや、それがまだ全然。風呂入って着替えたらまた事務所に戻る。
今夜も泊まり？
I asked my wife, I said, because I never hear my stomach growl, and I don't really hear it growling from other people, but I don't really hang out, you know, like for kids and stuff like that, or, you know, the stuff, but I guess it happens, because she said, yeah, she hears her own stomach growl sometimes, and hears it from other people, so, yeah, I don't know, I mean, but I tend to, like, at least, again, where I worked is, like, you tend to not work through, you know, you always had breakfast, you know, definitely military, you always had breakfast available if you wanted it, at lunch, dinner, and even, and on ship, then they had what's called mid-rats, like, let's say you had to work the midnight shift, you can still go down to the galley and get, you know, get food and whatnot, or if you had to, like, sometimes, like, when I was on 50 caliber watch, you know, on the very rare times, that was, then the food got delivered, but, yeah, you always try to make sure, you know, your people were well-fed. There was always that case. I didn't like the delivery because they tend to like get all the, I mean, holy crap, man, especially breakfast. It was like a bunch of hash brown hash. It's like, I try to avoid greasy foods. But yeah, when they're bringing it to you, you don't get much choice in matters. It's like, hey, what's ever in the food box? But yeah, never really, I kept thinking, because you keep seeing on, you know, on TV, it's like, it's a, especially Japanese television, make a big deal out of, you hear the growling, that means the person must be hungry. Even though they're saying they're not hungry. So I think it's kind of a, you know, it's a trope. It's like, oh, okay, you're really hungry, but you don't want to say you're hungry. Okay, got it. But now you get to eat.
Haruheta. いい匂いだな。
食べて。
食べて。食べて食べて。今あのほら、オムライス作ったんだよ。
いやでもそれはお前自分のために作ったんだろう。
いいの。ご飯2膳分だし。
ご飯全。So I think when he's saying zenbu, so I mean that means the two cups of basically, you know, two bowls of rice. Okay.
卵3個だし、鶏もも肉1枚全部入れちゃったから。
え？
あ。
あ。
とにかく座っていいから食べててね。
I mean that does look awesome. Now, by the way, because they're filming this scene, I'm pretty sure that's fake. That is got to be fake. Now, the cooking they don't fake. They have to do that for real. But that part has to be fake because you know they got to film the scene over probably quite a few times because the complexity of it. It's, I mean, it's not a complex scene, but again, they're having to move back and forth, and there's probably has to be quite a few takes to do this.
入れてくる、くるから。はい。
This looks like a single. Yeah, yeah, so they are doing multiple takes, yeah.
一緒に食おう。
いただきます。いただきます。
That looks okay, he took half. Where are we at here?
五臓六腑に染み当たるとはこのことだ。
五臓、so it means five organs, and six. Wait a minute. Bowels? Wait a minute. 五臓六腑. Okay, 腹の中. So the internal organ, internal heart. Let's see.Yeah, all the emerging internal organs. Okay. Five viscera and six entrails. The bowls and the bowels. And yeah, okay. Nieru kaeru. Makes me boil with rage. Okay, makes me inside boil. Yeah, seething with rage. Okay, so there's some different little statements you can work with this. Gozo roppu.五臓六腑に。Should be like, you know, basically being filled.
五臓六腑に染み当たるとはこのことだ。うまい。
Speaking of which, you know, I'm going to do something which is probably a very bad idea, but I'm going to do a search for this on Google. Okay, so there. Okay, goes a little. Oh, yeah, that's interesting. It makes a little alchemist symbol. So anyway, you got the liver, the pancreas, the lungs, the what was that, the spleen? And the heart, obviously. And then those are the so those are the internal organs. So what's the ropa? Is that like the guts? Yeah, right there. You don't see this one. So anyway, so there we also so we have it there. So we got again, that's the liver. Oh, and actually they got an even number. That's cool. So they got the liver, the heart, the I'm pretty sure that's the spleen. I think yeah, that's the spleen. It's not the gallbladder. I think that's the spleen, but I'm not sure. Lungs, kidneys. That's the is that the bladder? That's the bladder, right? Let's see, six. Maybe it's not the bladder. Is that where is that? No. That's the gallbladder. God damn it, that's the gallbladder. That's the little small intestines, large intestines, the stomach, actually this one. Oh wow, I really don't. Let's just look at the picture. Well, I mean, it looks right there. It looks like it's the bladder. And Sanshu, what is that? 11. Where's 11 at? I can't see where 11 is at. But I like that. Okay. Gozo ropa, ropu. Gozo ropu. So gozo and yeah, kidneys. I don't know, spleen. That is that the spleen? Is it? I mean, it's right there, so yeah, I guess it is. Huh. And then yeah. But what's number 11, son? I don't know. Anyway, sorry for getting distracted like that. It's just that it's one of those things where I know the kanji. I don't know how to pronounce them, right? You know the kanji because of they, you know, they were like very memorable ways to make stories like that for Heizig. Man, you know, again, they're appearing here, but it's like okay, and it kind of makes sense. Like you can probably from kind of think about, you know, the five major internal organs in the viscera to kind of think about that. But yeah, it's like basically, it's like. Basically, it's filling my bone. Like it's yeah, it's filling me up. Yeah, refreshing everything. Sorry about that.
本当? ああ、うまいよ。
まいよ。
それにこれ、
それに
ここ の3週間、
3
こういう
週
のろくに食ってなかった。
間。ロックに、オッケー。
この3週間、こういうのろくに食ってなかった。ケンジ、いろいろ作ってくれてたんだな。ありがとう。このオムライスも具たっぷりでいい。こんなうまいオムライス食べたことないよ。
よかった。
うまい。シロさんとの二人ご飯本当にしみる。
味濃くない？Not too thick? I assume
ちょうどいいよ。
ちょうどいいよ。
23円？
すごく頑張ったんだけど、今月23円しか余らせらんなかった。
すごいじゃないか。
え？
いや。
大したもんだよ。俺だって最近は結構頑張らないと2万5000円に収まらないのに。
そうなの？
でもな、たったの23円だしな。
何言ってんだよ。この23円は何倍も価値があるよ。
シロさんごめん、やっぱこっちにあったわ。こんぐらい大きい方がやっぱ着替えれるにはいいんじゃ。
ああ
、こんぐらい大きい方がやっぱ着替えれるにはいいんじゃ。
シロさんち、
うん、
もう少しだけいっか。
I hope And yeah, I do that, by the way. It's like, if like if I fall asleep in the chair, my wife gets mad at me. Yeah, she'll fall asleep on the sofa or on the chair, so I'll grab a blanket, put it over her. So that's very common. And yeah, she'll put a blanket over me if I lay down in the bed without the blanket on. So it's very common to, like, yeah, throw the blanket on someone if they're asleep. Don't wake them up. It's a, yeah, it's a thing. That's not a trope.
No! Ah! 破産完済人資格証明申請書、明日の朝9時までに作るんだった。
What's happening here? Why is it doing that?
ケンジ、破産完済人資格証明申請書。
Okay. So the, I remember that's the, debt, Hassan, so the, sorry, the bankruptcy administrator.Kanzai ni shikaku shomei sho shikaku shomei shinsei sho shikaku shomei shinsei sho Hassan, kanzai nin, shikaku shoumei, shinsei sho, ashita no asa. Okay.
Hassan, kanzai nin, shikaku shoumei, shinsei sho, ashita no asa 9時までに作るんだった。 Kenji, もう出るわ。 このバッグ、サンキュー。
あ、いいよ。
お前も、風邪とかひかないようにな。
あ、
じゃあな。
ああ、シロさん起きてたでしょ、ね、ねえ、シロさん起きてたでしょ。何それひどい、石神。ねえ、ちょっと待って、行ってきます。もう、何あれ。シロさん。
あ、
ケンジ、どうした？
シロさん、母さん、明日は一日雨だって。
ありがとう、助かった。
行こ
う。まだ雨降ってないぞ。
いいじゃん、誰も見てないんだし。
俺、シロさんと一度こうしてあいあい傘で歩いてみた。
あいあい傘。
で、あいあい傘で、俺、シロさんと一度こうしてあいあい傘で歩いてみた。
なんてね。
嘘だよ。はい。
でらっしゃい。
ちょっと歩こうか。
Sounds good. Yeah, this went a little, I'm surprised this went as long as it did. I mean, we're at an hour and 10 minutes. I started about 5 minutes into it. Again, it was probably just because it was a dialogue dense episode. So I don't know why it keeps doing that. Why is it going dark so fast? It's, yeah, I don't, it's a video. I mean, obviously the video doesn't matter as much. It is a let's read, not a let's watch. Still, you kind of like things working the way it is, and then there's a change, and it's not necessarily, it wasn't on purpose. Well, it was on purpose for Netflix, and then, of course, the application had to change or adapt to whatever changes Netflix made, and again, they're still trying to adapt. I will say, this was a good episode. I enjoyed the episode. Maybe I'll just keep it over there. And let me go back here. Sure. I did enjoy the episode. I enjoyed the series. I think I mentioned that. It's fun to watch. I've watched it a number of times after I've done these Let's Reads. Because, watch it with my wife. She enjoys the episode. That's a very good thing. Like, if you can find an episode to do these Let's Reads on that you can enjoy again. Either with another by yourself or with another person. But again, what you need to make sure to do after you do these Let's Reads is watch the show one more time. After you've done it. It could be immediately after or just roughly within a day or so if you can. And just enjoy it for the way it is, as opposed to like what I was doing now where I was just trying to follow along, get the story, understand, hey, what was the conflict going on or what was the issues going on? You can kind of, I mean, obviously I could follow along just by watching it, even if I didn't understand a single word as to kind of what was going on. As long as I knew who these two characters were, what their jobs were, you can kind of figure out what would be going on. So that's just context through just not, either knowledge of the story of itself. And that makes the stories in these Let's Reads get easier as you get closer to the end, regardless. This was a little complicated a bit because, again, they were talking about, they're in his office. So some of the legal terminologies pop up, not too much compared to previous episodes, but it was still enough where you had to look it up. Once I got into, once it got into the cooking, that part was, you saw that was fairly simple, and that went by pretty fast. But the beginning parts, when again just talking about, they're in a rush because they're taking all of these other court cases. It just, again, these are words. They're not, the vocabulary is not important. It's not a legal drama, so really that vocabulary, if I had skipped over it, not sweated all that much, it still would have been fine. No big deal. I did kind of maybe spend some time on the gozodopu. But again, I think that's kind of interesting, what they call it. Like, in English, we just say the internal organs. But there they say, like, the five major organs and then the viscera, like, basically the digestive organs. Which is also interesting. Yeah, and what I liked about this most of all is that, again, it's just fun to watch for the cooking. Because cooking is going to be an aspect of life that, it's going to be an aspect of most people's lives. Yeah, you might not spend too much time in the kitchen, but, you might be eating the food, and kind of knowing what goes into the food can be helpful. It's Japanese, traditional Japanese foods. So, with some different, some variety in there as well. But you see, this video just goes dark. Maybe I'll just give it up. All right, it is what it is. But yes, this was I think I mentioned before. I mean, I'm pretty sure I mentioned at the end of the episode 12 was that it's just a good series. It was a lighthearted. Yes, it's about a gay couple, but it's not about the political nature of being. A lot of the stories about with this, if it's not a comedy, it might have to go into their struggles. And some of it is there, but they're not looking at the extremes from their particular two point. I mean, obviously, when he grew up, his parents went and they were sort of accepting, but not really, of his. And I'm not sure about Kenji's family. I forgot. I may need to rewatch it again. But I'm getting the feeling like it wasn't as positive. Like he wouldn't be hanging out with his family. So, and you saw it with some of the, the couple, the older couple where he wanted to adopt his boyfriend so that, he can leave his he can leave everything in his will. Should he pass away, everything can go to his boyfriend. Not, he didn't want a single dime, a single cent to go to his parents. Probably there was like a very darker story dealing with their relationship, which is why he doesn't want anything going to them, especially if they were like, not only were they not supportive, but if they were actively working against him, that could, you know, again, there could be, you can see how, you know, when you get family, don't accept you for who you are, you know, a very internal, something that's like central to your being, you know, like who you want to spend time with, you know, that's something, you know, that's central to one's character. And that, you know, that can cause some, it's like, it's hard to like get over that. Like, you know, what you think of someone who I want to spend the rest of my life with, and you think that they're, you know, they're scum or something or dirt or filthy, then yeah, it's kind of hard to get over that. So again, I don't know. They didn't go into the story as to it, but again, you kind of hinted at it. So as far, and I don't know what the, like a Japanese community, the equivalent of LGBT, what the equivalent there in Japan. And I don't know. I do know it feels like Japan feels more openly and accepting of the LGBTQ crossdressers also. They're kind of accepting in a way, but I'm pretty sure like that's in the abstract, but maybe if it's like someone in your own family, that opens it, and that makes it, all of a sudden it's not so straightforward. But again, I don't know enough. I can't really comment on that. It just, I'm not in the position to comment. I just don't know. But yeah, as far as a series goes, I really liked it. I think it's a very good series. If you ever study it, it's going to be a very good series to study to try to improve your Japanese, especially if you're male, just because again, it's like the main cast is mainly, it's all male. So it's going to help with, probably you want to pick, you know, Shido as opposed to Kenji as far as how to talk, most likely. You know, maybe be careful. I mean, he's kind of stern and strict, but you know, I'm guessing, you know, as far as talking patterns, he's probably a good one to emulate. If you want to use dramas, which to kind of help with your emulation. Beyond that, yeah, it's like I said, most likely, and I'll mention this. This is what I usually do, because I posted a reply. Someone asked like, how much time do you spend immersion versus studying? And my reply normally is like, it depends on what level you're at. Like if you're at beginning stages, beginning and basic stages, where you're under 2,000 words, most of your time should be studying. Don't worry about immersion at all. You need to get yourself up to a level to where you can get a benefit from immersion. And if you're at such a low level, you're just not getting it. If you're going to immerse in the study material, the audio from, or the media from the stuff that you've studied. Try to do that. Now, for like, if you're doing, and it depends on whatever you're using. Now, again, I recommend Tango Dex because that comes with audio. I have done with Take Him as far as grammar, where I had natives read the audio, read the sentences out loud, so you could reference that. But now I'm, you know, again, I kind of got away from recommending that. Now I'm more like recommending the Shinkansen master books. But again, I haven't paid anyone to read those sentences out loud, so there's no, unfortunately, it's like nothing to offer my people of the Patreon, like an audio, if you decide to use like Shinkansen master grammar. And I don't recommend using text to speech. I don't recommend that. It's not, if you got a choice, I mean, it's not bad. It just, one is kind of teased to do, and there it will have some mistakes, and there's probably better. You're probably just better off if you're going to, the immersion you do can be half immersion where you're watching, you know, Japanese shows, maybe with English subtitles, watch it once like that. Or watching it, but you read a summary. So you get to, you know, again, you're getting the context. So you are able to enjoy what you're watching. But beyond that, don't be doing immersion on the idea you're going to be getting better Japanese. I don't think you're at a level if you're at a basic beginners. Cool. Now, next stage is intermediate. Let's say you pass up, you're around about 2,000 words under your belt, either by listening and also reading. Now you can start doing immersion. by immersion via studying, like I'm doing here, this Let's Read, that's when this comes into play. And you can, for your passive immersion, that's the more you, passive active means we like you're doing was what a Let's Read is. Means you look up stuff you don't know. You're actively trying to follow along. Passive is you're still paying attention. So, I mean, there's active. It does have your active attention. You're paying attention. But if you don't understand something because you didn't know a word, well, you just don't know that word. All right. And but you still want to depend on doing a lot more, some passive immersion with that. There's also background. Background should be audio of stuff that you've done active Let's Reads on, or may even be media from stuff that you've studied. But for the most part, you want that playing on loop, and it becomes active when you, it becomes passive media, passive immersion when you pay attention to it. When you're not paying attention to it, it's background audio, okay? It's a background loop. And it's playing on a loop, so it should be playing all the time. So it's something you can pay attention to, and you want it something that's more comprehensible, the better. But again, that's at the intermediate stages, and that's from 2,000 words to 6,000 words. When you get up to the more advanced stages, past 6,000 words, that's when, whereas your active reading and intermediate stages, like one-to-one, from your active reading to your studying is one-to-one. So you do a couple hours of active reading. Hopefully you're doing a couple hours of active study. If you only got 2 hours of time to dedicate, then do 1 hour of active reading, 1 hour of study. Okay, this kind of doing like that. But anyway, when you get into the advanced stages, you probably want to do it like 2-to-1, 3-to-1. So if you're doing active reading, let's say reading the news, reading books, reading shows like that, but you're active, as in you're looking up stuff you don't know. First of all, you want to try, hopefully, if you can, utilize a Japanese dictionary if possible. Beyond that, though, it's probably going to be a 2-to-1 or 3-to-1 ratio. So for every 3 hours of active reading, you know, maybe an hour and a half, hour to hour and a half of studying. You know, that's all. I mean, just you're probably going to get more from the active reading than you are. Now, you won't learn more words. You learn words slower, but you're getting you're consuming the media in a way where it's meant to be consumed, and you're getting better at it. And the audio that you do on Let's Read, you can then put into the background to listen on loop. And then also audio stuff that you are, you know, you start gauging stuff based on what is its readability. What is your chance of you understanding it? Near how close to 100% are you to understanding it? And you want the audio from stuff that you have a high level of comprehension at, playing on loop in the background, you know, again. But again, just depend on what is your level. But I think a mistake is at the beginning basic stage, they hear, oh, immersion is the way to learn. Yeah, but you don't understand. It only works if it's comprehensible. You don't understand shit right now. Learn first. Then go do the... Get into, because again, I get it. Immersion's fun if you can learn, but you got to have that level. It just, you don't have the strength level to move the weight at the moment. So build up your strength, then worry about moving. It's kind of like you can kind of build up some body strength. So now you can then do field work. You know, that's actually kind of a cool way of getting, you know, actually go out on obstacle courses, you know, and get that natural type of strength and endurance as opposed to just being in the gym. But you want to build up to that, to where you now you can get the more benefit from that natural type of environment. Plus gym's more structured, same as Anki, it's a more structured way of learning. So you can definitely cover the basics a lot faster and more efficiently. You know, that's all. But then you then need to branch out after that. I get that. It's just remember where you are at. Helps depends on where you want to focus your efforts. That's all. All right, I talked enough on that. That was this was a long video. I apologize, but it was, most of it was Let's Read Japanese, and it went up to about 1 hour 10. So I've been talking about 15 minutes. Most of it was about my feelings of the series. This little in part with you know, me talking about, hey, when do you want to do immersion? All right, that's about it. Thank you all very much. For those of you on YouTube, if you like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up and a comment. If you like the series, subscribe to see more. If you like the Let's Learn Japanese project, you can support it via the Patreon. And in the description, there's links to that, as well as to the website and the community Discord. Finally, if you'd like to hire me on commission, or, you know, basically you need the one-on-one advice, either get started or walk through for getting started, or you're, you know, trying to restart in a different direction, the hourly rates and the payments are on the Patreon. The link's also in the description. Thank you all very much. I'll be back with Time Taxi. Let's see right now. Yeah, hopefully I can do the two episodes, both the parts for Time Taxi today. And for those of you on YouTube, that'll be over the next 2 days as well. Thank you all very much, and see you next time. Later. And thank you, White Mouse TV, for the comment.